Hey, my name is Eric, and I'll be co-presenting with Monsur. So what we'll be talking about, first I'll be giving you an introduction to OAuth. So for those aren't familiar, OAuth is an open standard for authorizing data access on the web, sharing users' private data. We'll be going a little bit about the details of that, but mainly focusing on how that incorporates into a Gadget. Next thing we'll be talking about is OpenSocial. So in the case of iGoogle, you can create a really interesting open social gadget using OAuth to access a user's private calendar data, blogger data, contacts, what have you, with the Google Data APIs. Lastly, we're going to go into the Google Data JavaScript client library, which is a great JS library for reading and writing data on the web. It makes open social gadgets particularly easy. So here's some skeleton code that's sort of going to explain about the OAuth Flow. The OAuth Flow actually in iGoogle involves a pop-up window, and that gives the user the ability to grant or deny access to the data. So the first thing they see when they come to iGoogle is this sign into blogger in this example gadget. We've created an on-click handler for that. And so when they click that, this pop-up window pops up. This is a Google page, and they're choosing or denying access to their blogger data. And so if they choose to grant access, the gadget will refresh itself. And last but not least, this is the normal state of the gadget. The gadget's been authenticated, the token is registered in the OAuth proxy, and you can post away to Blogger via iGoogle, which is really cool. We'll talk about how to do this in OpenSocial, and then how much easier it is actually using the GData JavaScript client library. So I hope to see you there. We'll be at Google I/O in May.